The Shockers definitely helped each other on the court tonight, get a big win over SMU. And this, it has to feel so good, Coach, just to get a win, period. But a lot of things went well tonight. Did a lot of good things as a team.
Yeah, we thought we were better offensively, obviously, than we have been. But we've been playing better at home. That's a very good basketball team. Yeah. They shoot it well. They've got some really, really good shooters and some guys that can really score the ball, like pros. Like McMurray's going to be a pro, Witt's going to be a pro. I'm not saying NBA, but they have a chance because of the way they can score the basketball. Chargot, Mike, they spread the floor on you. It was hard with our five men to guard them, but on the other hand, our five men gave them problems when they rolled to the basket or posted up with Asbjorn and Jamie. What can you say about number four? You know, he struggles every game right before the game with his anxiety, and then he didn't have any anxiety on that last play. I mean, that was we call it the C play. He put he and Mark in a ball screen, let them see what they can get, you know, and he just went and made a play. It's a big time play by a senior, and then I warned him, the game's not over. They put more time on the clock, there's a second to go, and with the way this team can kind of step on their own foot sometimes. Just don't foul him with the big guy in front. Don't charge. He did a good job not charging. And then Eric, I said, just tip the ball. You don't have to catch it. Just tip it. Don't let them grab it. And Eric made the play. So tremendous win. We got a lot of good performances. Samaje was tremendous. Mm-hmm. 7 for 12. 17 points, 2 assists, 1 turnover, and obviously the big game winner. Eric Stevenson played one of his best games. He was out there competing, rebounding. He goes for 17 points as well, makes all of his free throws, and leads us in rebounding with 6. Jaime was really good down the stretch, scoring around the basket. Not so good in his first 25 minutes, to say. I thought Asbjorn was outplaying him. Asbjorn did some good things, 5 for 6. And gave us quality minutes. Ricky and Jamarius took care of the basketball. 7 assists, 1 turnover for the rookie. Ricky had 4 assists in his 11-41. So a lot of good performances. And that's what we need. We need more than 1, 2, sometimes 0 quality performances.
And depth sure paid off today.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of depth because of their NCAA sanctions and injuries. And, you know, they'll have more depth next year as that goes away. But, you know, nobody's going to feel sorry for them. Nobody feels sorry for us. You just got to play with what you've got. And tonight I thought we really competed at a high level and thank goodness came out with a win. That would have been a tough one to lose.
On the face of it, I know you'll never be happy giving up 83 points and 49% shooting. But as you mentioned, a lot of really good individual offensive players. And I thought especially in the second half, you at least made them work to make difficult shots.
Yeah, we're not going to beat anybody if we give up 45 in both halves. And I told them that at halftime. That proved to be true. We scored 85. We don't usually score 90. And we gave them 45 points. But, man, they run good offense. They space the floor well. They've got tremendous shooters. Isaiah Mike was just on fire in the first half, but we did a good job in the second half, relatively speaking. I mean, it's different. It's different. The talent level that we're going against night in and night out is a little better than what we've been used to. And then we're just not as good defensively with the youth and inexperience. But tonight we took a step, and hopefully we can build on that on Saturday afternoon.
McDuffie only got 25 minutes in the ball game, but you used him efficiently, offense, defense. And I thought he had more open looks this ball game because the other players had to be respected.
Absolutely. JB and Ricky were coming off those ball screens aggressively. Samaje had it going a little bit. We were able to throw it down low to Asbjorn or Jamie, either on a roll or on a hard post up. And it was a tough second foul on Marcus, man. That was a tough second foul. And I guess they let him play from that point forward. He ends up with 4, but, man, that second one was hard.
Well, Coach, enjoy this one for a few minutes, and then I know you get back to work for Tulsa.
We don't have much break. It's Saturday afternoon, so it's a quick turnaround. And we've got Tulsa Hurricane coming in, and everybody knows, you know, not a lot of love lost. I mean, I really respect their program and glad we're playing them now, but that's a pretty good team. And, you know, they run a matchup zone, and they've got some really, really good players in Jeffries and Taplin, so big guy Igbanu inside. So we've already been watching film on them. The scout's already in the can. Now it's just a matter of relaying it to the guys tomorrow.
All right, Coach. Yeah. Thanks. Great. Congratulations. Great job. Shocker head coach Gregg Marshall presents.